the human bone, a lot of people consider the human skeleton and more specifically bones the main framework of our body. It's easy to see why we would not be able to exist without bones, because they are the ones that keep all the organs and tissues on, while allowing us to stay mobile and go anywhere we want. It's very important to understand the bone structure and the role of our bones. This will give us a good insight into how important our bones are and why it's vital for us to study and assess the role of our bones. What is the human bone? Bones are basically rigid tissues that are a part of the vertebrate skeleton for mammals. The main role of bones is to protect organs while also producing white and red blood cells. They also assist with mobility, while also storing minerals and delivering support for the entire body. There are a multitude of bones and each one has its own distinct role and requirements within the body. But the main role of bones is to provide support for all our organs and systems. Which is the main component of the human bone? As we mentioned above, bones are made out of living cells, named osteocytes and osteoblasts, all of these which are embedded in a mineralized organic matrix. The main inorganic component of the human bone is hydroxyapatite, which is the dominant bone mineral. When it comes to organic components, we have the type 1 collagen as well as phosphate calcium and the hydroxyapatite. The type 1 collagen is actually composing up to 95% of the organic matrix, and the remaining stuff is a homogeneous liquid named the ground substance. Types of bones. There are 4 different types of bones in the human body. Long bones are thin and very long. They are in your arms and legs, and their primary focus is to be used as levers and help you move properly. Short bones have a cubed, squat shape. They can be found in your wrists and ankles, for example. Flat bones have a broad, flattened surface. They are found in your skull, breasts, shoulder blades and ribs. Lastly, we have the irregular bones. These, as the name suggests, tend to have a different shape to the other 3 above. The vertebrae are a great example here. What is the human bone anatomy made up of? Scientists state that an adult has anywhere from 206 to 210 bones, depending on the sternum counting. When we are born, we have around 300 bones, but as we grow we end up with 126 bones in the appendicular skeleton and 80 in the axial skeleton. It's important to note that many of the accessory bones like the sesamoid bones are not included in our counting. Our body has 20 major bones. As we age, our bones fuse, and this process continues until we are in our 30s. The anatomical variations show that some people can have less bones when compared to others. This is normal. Our bodies can function properly even if they have less bones, although it depends what bones we are talking about. How many bones do we have in our spine? The adult spine has 26 bones, however a child will have 34 bones. The cervical vertebrae has 7 bones, then there's the thoracic vertebrae that has 12 bones and the lumbar vertebrae that has 5 bones. Then we have the sacrum, which has 5 bones at birth and they are all fused into one. Lastly, there's the coccygeal vertebrae, which has a single bone. Why we lose bone marrow? Bone marrow is needed to produce white cells. These are used by our body to fight infections. In addition, bone marrow also generates red blood cells that we use to carry oxygen throughout our entire body. It even generates the platelets we need in order to stop bleeding. So yes, bone marrow is very important for our body, however there are situations when we end up losing bone marrow naturally. Blood marrow loss or failure can be acquired or inherited. Usually it's connected to all kinds of different diseases, but it can also be genetic as well. Then there's also the fact that chemotherapy and radiotherapy can lead to bone marrow loss and even immune system problems. Even things like aplastic anemia can be a major cause behind bone marrow loss. Also, our body can also lose bone marrow due to aging. As time goes by, our body ends up having less bone marrow, and that can become quite the issue. It's important to note that even exposure to chemicals like benzene can lead to bone marrow loss in the long term. How to prevent bone loss or replace bone loss. Osteoporosis is a widely common health issue where bones end up becoming weaker and weaker and they eventually break. This usually means bones in the wrist, backbone and hip end up being damaged and they can break as time goes by. What you need to realize that your bone is a living tissue. In order to keep your bones strong, you must break down the old bones and replace the new bone tissues. How can you prevent bone loss? There are some things to consider and focus on, as you will notice below. Make sure that you eat foods rich in vitamin D and calcium. These are very important for replacing any bone cells that were damaged or too old. Ideally, you want to exercise often too. Climbing stairs, dancing, tennis, jogging, walking, weight training and many other types of exercises can end up being very helpful for your body. It's important to not drink alcohol. The reason you want to avoid that is because drinking a lot can lead to bone loss. Another thing to avoid is smoking. This also leads to bone loss and it increases the number of potential fractures that you can deal with. Sodas are also dangerous for you. They have a lot of phosphorus and your body doesn't absorb calcium as much, which is something you need to take into consideration as much as possible. Medicine and medical products in general can actually help, however you shouldn't take any medical products like this without the guidelines of a doctor, just to be safe. Otherwise you will encounter problems, and that's stuff you want to avoid. The bone tissue layers. One thing we need to keep in mind is that the bone tissue ends up being formed out of multiple different layers. You have the periosteum first, which is the tough, dense outer shell which hosts nerves and blood vessels. Then there's the dense and compact tissue, which is a layer that's hard and protects the tissue found within. The spongy, cancellous tissue is porous and it's found in most bones. Its focus is to offer strength to the bone, while also keeping the bone as light as possible. Lastly, we have the bone marrow, which is found in the bone cavities and it's the one producing red, white blood cells and platelets. How often are bones rebuilt by our body? Although it might not seem possible, the truth is that our body is building up and also breaking down bone tissue as time goes by. So yes, every decade our bones are rebuilt. Of course, it's a long and tedious process, it doesn't just happen on the fly, but it's still interesting to study it and see how it all happens. It just goes to show the complexity of the human bones and how they are actually rebuilding themselves. Are all joints moving? Most joints will move in order to provide flexibility to our body. There are some immovable joints in our body. These include the articulations between the mandible and teeth and the skull sutures, for example. Then there are the joints between the sternum and first rib pair. There are also some joints that move very little, like the distal joint found between the fibula and tibia. Of course, we also have those joints that offer a lot of motion, like the ankles, hips, wrist or shoulders. They are usually found either in the lower or upper limbs, and they are very important since they help us move properly. Conclusion: the bone is very important when it comes to the overall structure and mobility of our body. However, while bones are strong, they can also be very fragile. That's why many health issues like osteoporosis can arise, especially when we don't take great care of our bones. eating a healthy diet, focusing on a proper workout routine and avoiding a lot of pressure on our bones is extremely important. On top of that, it's a very good idea to go to the doctor for a routine checkup just to be safe. Once you make these changes to your lifestyle, you can obtain some incredible results. Make sure that you take great care of your bones and you won't have to worry about any problems in the long run.